Well, that takes care of the Persian Gulf, Indonesia, and the Pacific shipping lanes. So what's happening in the rest of the world, huh?
What's left?
Hmm. What do you mean, no new worlds to conquer?
Ryan, all you've conquered here is a desk. That and a lot of paper names and places. You know, there are real ones out there. We could conquer them together.
Like you said last night, huh?
Well, why not? I mean, what is holding us here?
Well, there's sure nothing holding me, but there's quite a bit holding you, isn't there?
Me?
Yeah.
What do I have? I'm free. I'm single.
Well, for one thing, you have your family.
My family doesn't need me. Max is married. Elena's determined to ruin her life, no matter who gets in her way. She won't listen to me. Ricky's level-headed as they come.
Now, that doesn't mean they don't need you. Besides, you got your job here, right?
Used to mean a lot to me. Doesn't anymore.
Terry, you talked to Alex about this?
No.
Well, he's not going to let you go. He needs you too much. He depends on you. You realize that,
maybe,
right?
Maybe he did once. It was exciting then. You know, sometimes Alex and I worked all night, just the two of us. One minute we'd be on the brink of disaster, and the next we'd be looking at all the money in the world. You never knew which from day to day. But now you always know. Ryan, World Oil's too big. Nothing could hurt it very much.
Now, Alex needs more than a good executive assistant.
Well, he's got Iris now. I could disappear tomorrow, and it'd take Alex a week to notice I'd gone.
Uh-uh. You're wrong about that.
Okay, maybe. Like, it doesn't matter. Ryan, working with you has been like the old days. It's been like...
Wait, wait.
When Alex first started...
What are you saying?
I'm saying it's been good. It really has, and it could be better. I want to work with you, Ryan. I want to be at your side.
Yes. Thank you, Maria. Send her in.
Hi.
Hi, Ginny. How have you been feeling?
Not very well.
Sit down. How's the nausea?
Oh, the nausea's doing just fine. It's the patient who's not doing so hot. I'm just exhausted all the time, Bart. I feel like crying for no reason at all.
Well, you've been under a tremendous amount of strain. I'm not surprised you feel like that.
I know, but I wasn't like this with Steve. I never felt sick. I went horseback riding every day. I had more energy than ever.
Every pregnancy's different.
This different? When I was pregnant with Steve, I wanted to tell the whole world that I was going to have a baby. But now...
You still haven't told anyone?
Courtney and I talked about it, but that was only because she found my medical records.
I didn't tell her, Ginny. I knew you wanted this kept confidential.
I know. She came across them when she was looking for Barry's records.
I'm sorry. I should have been more careful. I should have filed them separately.
It's okay. Courtney understands. She really does.
You know, she's not the kind of person who makes judgments.
No, she doesn't.
Well, I'm glad you've got somebody else to discuss this with. I'm sure they'll be a tremendous help to you. Did she have any advice?
Yes, she told me what you did. Tell Ryan.
I think he has a right to know.
Ryan's leaving Houston, so this baby doesn't have anything to do with him.
Ginny, no matter where he lives...
The baby is not Ryan's problem.
And Barrett?
Well, I can't tell him. Not yet. Why not, Ryan?
Terry, look, you're tired. Too much has been happening too fast for you.
Tired? I feel like I'm... drifting farther and farther away from everybody, and nobody even notices.
Come on, you know that's not true. Everybody loves you.
Then where do I fit in? Why is everybody laughing and having a good time? Everybody but me.
Hey, not everybody, all right.
So then why don't you join me, Ryan? Then neither of us will be so lonely.
Terry, look. If I stayed with World Oil, believe me, I'd like nothing more than working with you. You understand?
Don't you see?
No, wait. I thought about this a lot last night. Just listen. Look at me. You're a beautiful woman. I have all the qualities to make any man happy, you understand?
Too bad nobody's interested.
You'd be wasting your time with me.
Ryan, it wouldn't be a waste of time.
It's no life for you.
I'll quit my job. The hell with it. The hell with everything.
Terry, you're not listening to me.
I mean it. I have planned my way into a blind corner. I'm sick of it. I want to throw away the plans. I don't want to be the level-headed Terry Decker anymore.
Terry, look, if Dennis Carrington sits behind this desk, he's going to need all the help he can get.
Oh, please, don't talk to me about duty.
I'm sorry. I wish I could say come with me, but I can't.
If Ryan's leaving town, getting out of your life...
I think it's best for everyone.
Especially Barrett, right?
Yes.
So you intend to act as if the child is Barrett's?
He's my husband. He'll make a wonderful father.
And are you going to be able to live with the fact that you're not being completely honest with him?
I have no other choice.
There are choices, Ginny. You can tell Barrett the truth.
No.
You can tell Ryan. You can marry him.
No. I can't leave Barrett. I have a responsibility to him.
Are you confusing responsibility with pity?
Bart, Barrett survived because of me. Because of his love for me and my love for him. I won't take that away from him now. I can't.
All right. When are you going to tell him you're pregnant?
Well, I want to... wait as long as I can. Otherwise, he might suspect that the child is Ryan's.
Don't wait too long.
I won't. Bart, is there anything that you can give me so I can keep going?
No.
I'm shaking all the time. I feel so exhausted.
There are too many risks for the baby, especially in the first 12 weeks.
But there must be something mild and safe that I can take.
I'd rather not prescribe anything unless it's absolutely necessary.
Do you want to examine me now?
Yes, I'll just call Maria and ask her to come in and help you.